Hi guys, Misty here with Queen Bee's Vintage. Welcome to or welcome back to our channel. In today's video, I am going to be sharing my Halloween decorated coffee bar with you guys. As we explained in our video yesterday, Mom and I didn't have time to do the Halloween decorating that we normally do in our homes due to our busy show schedule. So yesterday we showed you what little bit Mom did in her dining room. And today I'm going to show you my coffee bar, as that is the only area of my house that got decorated this year. What I did is I took some gifts that I received from friends and family this year, as well as some Halloween pieces that I keep stored here at the house, in order to create this look that I did in the coffee bar. I also used some souvenirs that I picked up while we were at Disneyland on our recent vacation, and they're super cool. So I hope you enjoy. And if you guys like today's look, the top and the jewelry that I'm wearing, it can be found on our website at www.queenbeesvintage.com. And from now until midnight tonight, you guys can receive a 15% discount on your order. In the promo box at checkout, just use the word Queen Bees, B-E-E-Z, all one word, no caps and no spaces, with the number 15, and you'll receive that discount. So let's head on over to my coffee bar. Alrighty, friends, let's go in and take a closer look. On my cabinet door, I have this really cute tea towel or dish towel that my mom made me. No witching in the kitchen. I love this little towel and I put it out every year. I have draped the coffee bar with this lace and fringe piano scarf. So taking a look at the top of the coffee bar here, I have my Ray Dunn Spirits and Treats canister, a silver glass skull, and these cute little witch boot salt and pepper shakers. And as you guys may have seen in one of our haul videos, my mom purchased this cute Witch's Brew faux vending machine cabinet for me this year. And inside I just have a cute, sorry about the glare guys, a cute orange mug with a witch on her broomstick. Over here in this little hanging jar, I have some skull and crossbone stir sticks, as well as some gold and black and white paper straws. On top of the vending machine, I have a little Beware of the Wicked Witch and Her Little Monsters Live Here sign. And Mom purchased this for me. I believe these were from Dollar Tree. This sign and one other one that I'm going to show you. I got the broom parking only sign from a friend. And then back down here on the top of the bar, I have a little Ray Dunn scaredy cat dish with my little ceramic cauldron inside. And no coffee bars complete without some after coffee mints that are in this cute sugar skull tin. Got a few more of my skull and crossbone stir sticks in this cute spooky owl mug, a little Ray Dunn witch hat mug, and then I just have my coffee canister with a rest in peace tombstone candle set in front of it. And I put some of these black and white sparkly pumpkins in the little basket that holds my extra syrups. These were purchased at Walmart. And then I just have some fun Halloween napkins down inside there as well. So giving you an overall view of my shelves, you can see that I have some little crow lights and some witch hat lights. The crows have a clear, warm white light to them, and the witch hats have orange. And you'll see those a bit closer up, but I just kind of wanted to give you another overall shot of the shelves. So on this first shelf here, I have this cute Hocus Pocus sign that my sister gave me for my birthday, along with this fun Ouija board looking sign that we picked up in the bullseye section at Target. And then these awesome apothecary jars are souvenirs from Disneyland. These were new this year, I think for their 50th anniversary. And what they are supposed to be are apothecary jars with captured spirits from the Haunted Mansion. And for those of you that are familiar with Disneyland, you know that they just reinstalled the Hatbox Ghost into the Haunted Mansion just a few years ago. He had been gone for quite some time. So of course I had to get the Hatbox Ghost jar. I got Constance Hatchaway, the bride. And then Victor Geist, he is the organist in the Haunted Mansion. And this particular jar was a season pass holder only jar. So only those that had a season pass could purchase him. So I had to get one of those because they are more limited. But they're very cool because the top of the lid is decorative and says Haunted Mansion. They each have a cute little chain around them with a charm. This one has the hat and the hat box. But when you push on them,
be sure to bring your death certificate.
So they play music, and then on the back side, I want to turn this around. Hopefully I'm not going to knock everything over.
Family, friends, next of kin, summon a spirit from the mansion. Ghoulies travel from near and far, all invited to reside in a jar.
So you can see the little spirit lights up in each jar. So that one was the Hatbox Ghost. The bride shows the bride. And then Victor, the organist, it shows him inside the jar. So there were 9 jars in total. I only bought 3. They were a little pricey. They were $60 a piece. But for major Disney fans, you know, sometimes you are willing to pay a little bit more for some of their cooler souvenirs. And then this fun mug, it's actually a souvenir cup holder. So with it open, you could put one of your Disney sodas or drinks that you buy in the park down inside the mug and carry it that way. But I've put a battery operated tea light candle down in here. And I just think it's really fun. And then I've just got a little black spooky plant and a little cauldron tucked back behind there. So we have that shelf there. On this next shelf, I have this awesome Sugar Skull bust. This was purchased as a gift from some friends of mine a few years ago for my birthday. I believe they purchased it through Grandin Road. I'm not sure if she's still available, but I absolutely love her. And in my little tiered stand I use up here, I put this Eat, Drink, and Be Scary. I think this is another dollar store sign that Mom picked up for me. Then I have these cute spooky tags that she made me, gosh, probably about 7 years ago, tucked in there. I have this fun little oddities candle. It smells super good too. And over here, I just have a succulent in an urn. And next to it is my Headless Horseman ornament that I picked up at Disneyland as well. And there's just a black pumpkin tucked back behind that. And then on this shelf, as I said, I have my Victor Geist in his apothecary jar. I have a black skull candle, my Ray Dunn Spirits cutting board, a cute little blackbird with a witch hat that I purchased at the Target dollar spot, and then my Ray Dunn fly birdhouse has been transformed with the use of some vinyl that a friend of mine cut out for me. Thank you, Heather. It's a little witch on her broom with her black cat and some black bats. And next to that, I have this fun Halloween picture. It's a witch's brew recipe. This is also a Ray Dunn piece. And next to it, I have tucked a black and white plaid pumpkin from the Target bullseye section. And inside it, I just did an arrangement with some, they're kind of a purpley blue-gray colored hydrangea that I picked up at the Dollar Tree with a black raffia bow. And you can see I've got these cute little black witch hats. You can see their orange lights now. And up on the top shelf, I just have my, you know what? I'm gonna step up, guys, and show you this. Give me a second. Okay, so on this top shelf, I have my grow watering can from Ray Dunn, and it's just got more of those hydrangeas and some berries in it. A little trick-or-treat sign, I believe this was also Dollar Tree, with some cute pumpkins from Target Dollar Spot on top. And this is my other Disney souvenir. He is one of the hitchhikers from the Haunted Mansion, and there's a tombstone back behind him. And what they did is when you bought popcorn, they slid the box of popcorn down into the open tombstone. So I just think he's cute and a lot of fun. So I'm gonna step down. I'm gonna show you my mugs that I have hanging on my mattress springs and one other little thing, and we'll wrap this up. So for those of you that have seen some of my other coffee bar tours, you know that I took the mattress springs from my son's crib and hung them on the wall. And this is how I hang my mugs in my coffee bar area. So what I did is I have just some regular everyday mugs, and what I've done is mixed in some of my black mugs that I have and some Halloween. So the Boss, Hustle, Boss Lady, and Coffee are our regular everyday black mugs, but I have Lazy Bones, Zombie, Boo, Momster, and I have two Cheers Witches mugs, and then the fall one says fall on one side and y'all on the other, and it's orange on the inside. And at the bottom of this, I just hung this cute little Come In My Pretties arrow that I picked up at the 99-cent store this year. And on my bedroom door, I put this Old Salem Black Hat Inn sign. It's topped with a black and orange raffia bow. The raffia was picked up at Target in their bullseye spot this year. And that is it, guys. This is my Halloween-themed coffee bar for 2019. Again, I apologize that I wasn't able to do any fun Halloween DIYs for you guys this year, and I wasn't able to do a full Halloween home tour. Next year, I'm hoping to have things planned better and, you know, adding those three additional shows to our schedule that we don't normally do kind of threw everything through a loop. So hopefully from here on out, we are back on schedule. We really appreciate everyone's patience with us while we were away. We love and appreciate all of your support and wonderful comments that we have received. And we will be back tomorrow with a fun DIY. So we hope you'll come back and see us. So until next time, we hope you guys have a great day. Bye-bye.